Welcome back, guys. WTF Game Nation. This is Peanut Butter.
And this is Toast of Butter.
Coming to you from Game Nation Studios with the third installment of this comprehensive breakdown on how we dismantle the Last Wish raid. The third installment of this video focuses on the giant booger ogre, Swolgoroth, or as his mother calls him, Morgoth. This is one of the easier encounters in the entire raid, but it's very easy to get behind. And once you do that, you'll result in a wipe 9 out of 10 times. Morgoth is sitting hunched on top of the stage, blocking the way forward. And in front of him is a Taken Orb. This is called Taken Strength, and it empowers Morgoth with Taken Strength. Our goal is to take that strength away from him. If any remains on the field, it will empower Morgoth, and once his strength reaches 100%, you're wiping.
We will want to take various Taken Strengths off of the field as soon as they spawn. However, you may never have more than two Taken Strengths at a time, so you'll want to plan out who is taking each strength and at which time. The spawns for the strength are very predictable. You will have one strength in the middle to start the encounter, then after some time your first wave of Taken Strength will spawn, which consists of two Taken Strengths on the right and two on the left. These will be on different elevations, one up high and one down low for each side. After a few mechanics take place, there will be another wave very similar to the last one, two on the right and two on the left. And finally, there will be one last Taken Strength in the very middle where the initial strength was, and when you grab this, it will begin DPS. As predictable as these spawns are, if someone dies with Taken Strength, that strength will return to the field in random spots, which can easily throw off all of your plans. Now that we know where all 10 bits of Taken Strength are, let's talk about everything you do in the meantime.
As the encounter begins, you'll want to split off with three people on the right and three people on the left. Taken Scions will spawn on the top and bottom of each side. These little guys will duplicate quick if you leave them unchecked. So as always, get them ASAP. Very soon after this first spawn, you'll have a Taken Ogre spawn top right, top left, as well as two ogres that will spawn in the middle. Take them down quickly. After a few more waves of Scions, the first set of Taken Strength will spawn, two on the left, two on the right. And then most immediately after this, you will have two major Taken Vandal Snipers, as well as two Taken Captain Eyes of Riven, like the ones from Shirochi. These four major enemies will spread across all four corners of the map, but the designation for which one spawns where is random. Look out for the Eyes of Riven. This will be very important, as Morgoth will attempt to capture a teammate with the most Taken Strength, killing them and thereby returning their strength to the field. However, since we know he captures someone with the most strength, we can plan accordingly. The orb from the Eye of Riven will be used to free the captured teammate. As before, you can utilize the Eye of Riven to shoot enemies, while your super will be saved and used to stagger the boss during DPS. Your grenade button will be used to cleanse, which in this instance is what frees your teammate. Cleansing your teammate removes their Taken Strength and applies it to you. If you're cleansing, you want to make sure you do not have any Taken Strength. That way you do not accidentally end up with three stacks of Taken Energy, for this will kill you.
This is how we organize all of this. You have one person designated as the first person who will start the encounter by grabbing the first Taken Strength. They will also be the one to grab the final strength that begins DPS. A note to this person. When grabbing the Taken Strength to begin DPS, come at it from a side angle. If you go straight forward, not only will Morgoth shoot you, which is very painful and kills quickly, but Taken Ogre Eye Blast will also push you backwards. Not good. So starting in cover and then going from the side is the safest bet. This teammate will also be assigned to the right side for ad control. Teammates number 2 and 3 will be on the left side for ad control. And during both waves of Taken Strength at spawn, they will be taking one strength each. One person assigned to the top, and one assigned to the bottom. Teammate 4 will take both of the Taken Strengths on the right side as soon as they spawn, and then immediately get into cover. Since he is the only fire team member with two Taken Strengths, we know he will be trapped. As soon as he grabs both Taken Strengths, have him go behind the tree, somewhere that is safe and easily accessible to be cleansed. After being cleansed, he will no longer have Taken Strength, so it will be his job to grab the next two that spawn on the right side. Teammates 5 and 6 are the cleansers, and they will be left and right, respectively. Their job is to look out for the Eyes of Riven, kill them quickly, and then pick up the orb to cleanse the teammates. Preferably have the right cleanser to be the first person to cleanse, since you are already planning for the first person captured to be on the right side.
After that first cleanse, continue add control, and you will have the second round of Taken Strength spawn on the field, which must be picked up immediately, followed by a new set of Eyes of Riven and Vandals. Only kill one of the Eyes of Riven on the field. Leave the second one up for another 15 to 20 seconds. You may need this eye later, and you don't want it to go away too soon. The orb dropped by this newly downed Eye of Riven should be picked up immediately by the cleanser on the left as they prepare to cleanse whoever is captured. As long as this plan was followed, and no one died with the Taken Strength, there is no longer any strength on the field. Save the last strength, and this will spawn to begin DPS. Clear all remaining adds, including the Eye of Riven you left standing, while the first teammate, the one who began the encounter, grabs the last Taken Strength, and that will initiate the DPS phase.
Now, there are two different really strong strategies for DPS that will result in a one phase, and both require a Well of Radiance. First off, you can use the Whisper of the Worm. Plant that well back by the rally flag. Make sure you do not have Lunafaction boots equipped, as they will counteract the White Nail perk on the Whisper. Here you are aiming for the bulbous portion on his back. Make sure you proc Whispered Breathing and then fire away. The second and slightly easier strategy for DPS requires a shotgun. And as usual, the EP shotgun is best here. For this instance, you want the well planted behind Morgoth's foot with Lunafaction boots equipped this time. Be careful not to plant the well too soon, or Morgoth will slam you. Wait for him to remain still, then plant the well, then you can go in DPS with a shotgun. Everyone will stand in the well and shoot their shotguns at the bulbous Taken spot on his hip joint. If you have the EP shotty, make sure you melee Morgoth to proc the Trench Barrel perk. Both of these strats should result in a one phase, but if you are behind on DPS, make sure you have someone ready to grab the orb from the Eye of Riven that you killed right before DPS began. Using this super from the Eye of Riven on Morgoth will stagger him, beginning the second phase. At this point, rinse and repeat to finish the job. While you're doing DPS, Morgoth will shoot Axion darts at you. If your DPS is quick and you're burning him quickly, you won't have to worry about those hitting you. But if you have one person designated with a high fire rate weapon, like a pulse rifle or an auto rifle, they can take down these Axion darts before they get to the rest of the team.
As you might have noticed, there's no reference to the challenge on this stage here. That's because Bungie hasn't released it to date. If everything stays according to plan, we should be seeing it next week. We'll release a new video with the steps and plans on how to complete the challenge mode for Morgoth. If all of these steps were achieved, you're now celebrating being halfway done with this raid. Hang in there, man. It just gets harder from here. If you missed the video for the preceding encounter, Shirochi, be sure to click the link below. And if these strats worked for you, please hit the like button. And if they really worked for you and you want to see more, hit the subscribe button so it's easy for you to see the next encounters. If you have different strats or better strats, please let us know in the comments below. Thank you very much for spending some time with WTF Game Nation. We'll see you on the next one.